Hi there, welcome back to the Learn Scriptcase from Scratch course. We're continuing part four today where we're looking at all the different applications and building our system out. This video is going to look at calendars. So my name is Nate Carpenter and I'm the Scriptcase instructor leading this course. So as you can see, if you look at the course outline, we're on part four here with applications. We're almost done with this section. It's the largest section. So let's look at how we're going to use calendars. So as you know, we're using Global Music Supply as a fictional case study to kind of guide us developing our system throughout this course. So David is the CEO. We were introduced to him in one of the previous videos. And he schedules sales for certain products. So perhaps sheet music goes on sale for like 20% off or something for a certain period of time. And he does that using a Google Calendar. He wants a way to do this in our new application, in our inventory system. So the salespeople have access to it and know what is on sale, but he also wants to keep it in sync with his Google Calendar. So Scriptcase calendar applications are really neat. They do a lot for us. It can be a fully functional calendar all on its own, but we can also synchronize it with a Google Calendar. So we're going to look at how to do that, how to connect it to the Google API and a little bit of the developer console with Google, and then set that up so that it can synchronize with the Google Calendar for this. So let's go ahead and get started over in our Scriptcase development environment for this. Okay, so we're back in our sales folder again. We're going to build one more application for our salespeople, and that's a calendar application like we said before. So let's click new application here and go ahead and wait for that to load, and then we're going to choose calendar application. So we've learned a lot of different types of applications so far. We're almost done, and we're going to choose calendar this time to see what we can do with that. So we can go ahead and name this calendar application. I'm going to call it Sales Cal, and then we can select our table. So you can have an already existing table structure, or you can have Scriptcase create one for us, which we are going to do. So you can name that table. I'm going to call it Sales Cal so that it's named correctly, and go ahead and click create on that table. So it's going to generate the SQL for us automatically, and then we can edit the fields here. For the form side of this, there's a form side and a calendar side of this application. And then we can link the fields we need to the fields on the table, which is done automatically for us since Scriptcase created it. And then we can go ahead and click create on this and get started with our calendar application. So once this loads here, you can see a little bit, there's calendar settings and form settings. So the form settings are pretty much like forms that you've seen before in this course. And then the calendar settings are going to be new. Let's go ahead and run this to get started with it. This is a fully functional calendar all on its own. So you don't necessarily need the Google Calendar, but let's go ahead and see what this looks like without it. And then we can look at how to add the Google Calendar as well. So let me go ahead and switch to that. And as you can see, this looks very nice and similar to a Google Calendar. You can click on a day and you can go ahead and add an event. So this is the form side of this, and you can edit this just like you would any form in Scriptcase, but it's pre-built for you, so you don't have to do all this work. So you can do a start date and time, end date and time, do it all day, set up if it recurs or not, and so forth. And then once you're ready to go, you can click add. We're going to click exit for now. You have different categories and so forth. You can change it to month, week, day, or schedule. So a lot of different options for this calendar. Now let's go ahead and look at the form here. So you have the calendar settings and the form settings. So if you expand the form area, you have all the settings that you would see with the form. So if you wanted to change the categories, you could go to the fields and categories here. And then change those. So you could take ones off, you could put them on, whatever you want to do there. So you've edited forms, you've looked at how to do that, so we're not going to get into that too much. And then we can go to Google API here under the calendar settings to look at how to add our Google Calendar. So wait for that to load here. It's taking just a second. So the first thing we need to do is toggle the setting on to integrate, and then we need to get the JSON information for this. So here's what it's going to allow us to do with our Google Calendar, so we can insert, update, and delete events to our Google Calendar. And if we go over here to the Scriptcase documentation under calendar and calendar configuration here, we have a Google API section. So we need to go to the Google Developer Console and set up some credentials, as well as an OAuth screen too. So I have some things set up over in my Google API calendar, Google API settings here, but here's step-by-step instructions for how you can set it up on your own as well. So let's go over to my developer console, and I've got some API credentials here, and I've got a authorization URL, which is the URL directly to my calendar application. And you need to make sure you include the index.php after that, since that is the actual redirect, and include the correct domain. Then you can download the JSON here. I've already downloaded here, but you need to download that. Then you can open it up and copy the contents of that file into our JSON field on our calendar application right here. Once that is done, you can go ahead and run this, and this should be set up to run using the Google integration, Google Calendar integration. So let me go ahead and wait for this to generate, and then we can switch over there, and we're going to see some new buttons. So it's going to authenticate us. We select a Gmail account, click allow to allow access to it. And here we can use these buttons. We can export to a Google Calendar, whichever one we want, select our calendar and export, or we can input here. So click import and select our calendar we want to import. So I've got GMS sales here. I'm going to import that. It's going to process. And there we go. We have our new events that we added to our calendar. So, and then we can edit that. So that's 10% off orders of 500 or more. We could edit it to make it longer, shorter, etc., and then sync it with our Google Calendar. So that's how you use calendars in Scriptcase to have a standalone calendar or integrate it with your Google Calendar.